Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. I'm your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we will discuss 5 questions from PIB News. This session PIB 24/7 is beneficial for various government exams like UPSC, state PSCs and RBI. So let's begin with the session. So first question for today is National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Diseases and Stroke, which is being implemented by central government under the National Health Mission. For cancer, the focus is on 3 common cancers except. So this NPCDCS, National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Disease and Stroke, which in short is NPCDCS, was launched in 2010 in 100 districts across 21 states initially. And it was launched to prevent and control the non-communicable diseases. Non-communicable diseases ko prevent karne ke liye NPCDCS was launched in 2010 in 100 districts across 21 states. Every year on 4th of February, World Cancer Day is observed by Union for International Cancer Research, which is headquartered in Geneva. And the theme for this year, that is 2020, was I am and I will. I am and I will. And on this day, that is on World Cancer Day, WHO along with its agency, International Agency for Research on Cancer, launched World Cancer Report. World Cancer Report. And according to this report, 1 in 10 Indians to have cancer in their lifetime and 1 in 15 Indian to die of cancer. Okay, so according to this report, 1 in 10 Indians to have cancer in their lifetime and 1 in 15 died of the disease cancer. Now according to the National Cancer Registry Program of ICMR, the estimated number of mortalities of cancer cases reported in the country during the last 3 years is, in 2017 it was 7,66,000, in 2018 it was 8,01,000 and in 2019 it is 8,38,000. So ye jo hai badhta hi chala ja raha hai gradually year by year. Okay. And the government of India is taking major steps to tackle the problems regarding cancer. And under the National Health Mission, the focus is on 3 common cancers, which are breast cancer, cervical cancer and oral cancer. And let me tell you one thing, that the most common cancer in the world is lung cancer, while in India, the most common cancer is the breast cancer. Also, the cancer is covered under various schemes like Ayushman Bharat, which is Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, under which 5 lakh rupees is provided per family to those poor and deprived families which are deprived of secondary and tertiary health cares. And next is affordable medicines and reliable implants for treatment, which in short is AMRIT. Under this scheme, retail outlets are opened to sell medicines to heart patients and cancer patients at a discounted price. Heart patient or cancer patients ko discounted prices pe medicine dene ke liye retail outlets khole jate hai under the scheme AMRIT. And jo pehla AMRIT center tha was set up at AIMS, which is in New Delhi. AIMS New Delhi mein pehla AMRIT center open kiya gaya tha. And under Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi, a financial assistance of 2 lakh rupees is provided to the BPL families jisme koi bhi member suffer kar raha hai by a major life threatening disease. Okay, BPL families ko provide kiya jata hai isme, agar uska koi member kisi major life threatening diseases se suffer kar raha hai to usko one time financial assistance provide karaya jata hai of 2 lakh rupees under Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi. Okay guys, so the question was, for the cancer, the focus is on 3 common cancers, which are oral cancer, breast cancer, cervical cancer, except blood cancer. So the answer to this question is D, blood cancer. Next question is, Lok Sabha passed the Indian Institutes of Information Technology Laws Amendment Bill 2020, which will grant statutory status to 5 Indian Institute of Information Technologies IITs in PPP mode and declare them as institutions of national importance. What extra power these institutions will have on being declared as institutions of national importance? Now, what is institution of national importance? So guys, institution of national importance, it is basically a status which is conferred to higher educational institutions by an act of parliament. Okay, higher education institutions ko ye status diya jata hai, un higher education institution ko diya jata hai which are premier in their fields. Okay, so by an act of parliament. Alright, and ek baar ye status mil jata hai, then they are देन उनको पावर मिल जाती है कि वो डिग्रीज को ग्रांट कर सकते हैं. नाउ दे कैन ग्रांट डिग्रीज और डिप्लोमास टू द स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ ऑलरेडी देर आर 15 IIITs विच आर इनकॉर्पोरेटेड एज इंस्टीट्यूशंस ऑफ नेशनल इंपॉर्टेंस. नाउ आफ्टर दिस बिल 5 मोर इंस्टीट्यूट्स विल बी इंक्लूडेड एंड विल बी गिवन द स्टेटस ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस ऑफ नेशनल इंपॉर्टेंस विच आर भागलपुर इन बिहार, सूरत इन गुजरात, रायचूर कर्नाटका, भोपाल MP एंड अगरतला इन त्रिपुरा. एंड बिफोर दिस दे आर रजिस्टर्ड एज सोसाइटीज अंडर द सोसाइटीज रजिस्ट्रेशन एक्ट ऑफ 1860 एंड डू नॉट हैव द पावर टू ग्रांट डिग्रीज और डिप्लोमास. नाउ आफ्टर बींग डिक्लेयर्ड इंस्टीट्यूशंस ऑफ नेशनल इंपॉर्टेंस दीज इंस्टीट्यूट्स विल बी ग्रांटेड पावर टू ग्रांट डिग्रीज. ऑलराइट, सो द आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन इज वॉट एक्स्ट्रा पावर दीज इंस्टीट्यूशंस विल हैव ऑन बींग डिक्लेयर्ड एज इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ नेशनल इंपॉर्टेंस. सो द पावर टू ग्रांट डिग्री इज द राइट आंसर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एग्जीबिशन कम फेयर एकम फेस्ट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज फ्रॉम 2 March टू 9 March 2020. विच नेशनल लेवल डिपार्टमेंट हैज ऑर्गेनाइज दिस फेस्ट अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट हेडेड बाय थावर चंद गहलोत हु इज राज्यसभा MP एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द लीडर इन राज्यसभा. नाउ दिस इन एकम फेस्ट ई स्टैंड फॉर एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, के स्टैंड फॉर नॉलेज, ए स्टैंड फॉर अवेयरनेस एंड एन स्टैंड फॉर मार्केटिंग. एंड दिस फेस्ट इज एन एफर्ट फॉर प्रमोटिंग एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एंड नॉलेज अमंग द दिव्यांगजन कम्युनिटी. दिव्यांगजन कम्युनिटी के अंदर एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप को प्रमोट करने के लिए और उनकी नॉलेज को एनहांस करने के लिए दिस एकम फेस्ट वॉज लॉन्च बाय नेशनल हैंडीकैप्ड फाइनेंस डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन विच इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट. And in ACOM, E stands for entrepreneurship, K stands for knowledge, A stands for awareness and M stands for marketing. So the correct answer to the question is National Handicapped Finance Development Corporation. And guys, this National Handicapped Finance Development Corporation was set up in 1997 under Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment as a non-profit organization. And it was set up to provide financial assistance to the persons with disabilities for their economic upliftment. जो person with disabilities है उनके economic upliftment के लिए this National Handicap Finance Development Corporation provides financial assistance and it was set up in 1997 as a non-profit organization under Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment headed by Thavarchand Gehlot. Now next question is Union Minister for Women and Child Development Smriti Zubin Irani released a book titled Chronicles of Change Champions. The book is a compilation of 25 innovative initiatives taken at the state and district level under one of the Prime Minister's flagship scheme. So we have to identify the scheme, okay, under which this book Chronicles of Change Champions has been released by Minister for Women and Child Development Smriti Zubin Irani, who is Lok Sabha MP from Amethi. So now let me give you some hints about the scheme. So guys, this scheme was launched in 2015 and it is a joint initiative of Ministry of Women and Child Development, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare headed by Dr. Harshvardhan, who is Lok Sabha MP from Chandni Chowk, and Ministry of HRD headed by Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Haridwar. Now this scheme is a joint initiative of these three ministries and this scheme was launched to ensure protection, survival and education of the girl child. Okay, to ensure the protection, survival and education of the girl child, this scheme was launched in 2015. And let me give you one more hint. This scheme was launched from Panipat, which is in Haryana. Okay, and one more hint is that there are two components of this scheme, which is mass communication campaign and multi-sectoral intervention. Okay, so now can you identify the scheme? Yes, the scheme is Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme. So under the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme, which was launched in 2015 under three ministries, this scheme ensures protection, survival and education of the girl child. The scheme was launched from Panipat, Haryana. And there are two components of the scheme, which are mass communication campaign and multi-sectoral intervention by states and UTs. So under this scheme, Minister for Women and Child Development Smriti Irani released a book titled Chronicles of Change Champions, which is a compilation of 25 innovative initiatives taken at the state and district levels. Alright. So this Beti Bachao Beti Padhao was launched in 2015, which provide convergent efforts to ensure survival, protection and education of the girl child. Alright. So next question is, the average annual per capita water availability in India in the year 2001 was 1816 cubic meters and 1545 cubic meters in 2011. This may further reduce to 1486 cubic meters in the year 2021. So what is the main and basic reason for reducing average annual per capita water availability in India? So guys, agar hum is trend ko dekhe, jo hamara average annual per capita water availability hai, so in 2001 it was 1816 cubic meters, in 2011 it was 1545 cubic meters, in 2021 it is assumed that it will be 1486 cubic meters, and in 2031 it is assumed that it will be 1367 cubic meters. So agar hum is trend ko dekhe aur apni badhti hui population ko dekhe, so can we say that the major reason to this is the population? Yes, because agar hum kehte hain ki kahin pe water ka excess use ho raha hai, to wo excess use kyon ho raha hai? Because of the increasing population. Agar hum kehte hain ki kahin pe pani ka wastage ho raha hai, to wo kyon ho raha hai? Because of the lack of awareness. And lack of awareness kyun aa rahi hai? Because population increasingly badhti chale ja rahi hai, so government aur jo civil society hamari wo itna effort nahi laga pa rahi ki har ek insaan ko jo hai aware kiya jaye. So jo basic reason hai of almost all the problems, theek hai, almost problems ka India mein jo basic reason hai, that is population. Agar population hamari kam hogi to hamare resources acche se distribute ho payenge, hamari government acche se dhyan de payegi, har ek सिटीजन को प्रॉपर अवेयरनेस प्रोवाइड करा पाएगी. सो अगर हम इन ऑप्शंस को देखें तो सारे ऑप्शंस लगभग ठीक लगेंगे हमें, बिकॉज एक्सेसिव यूज ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर फॉर इरिगेशन करेंगे उससे भी जो हमारा पानी है वो कम होगा, लैक ऑफ गवर्नमेंट अटेंशन, पुअर मैनेजमेंट ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, लैक ऑफ अवेयरनेस इन पीपल एंड इंक्रीजिंग पॉपुलेशन ऑफकोर्स. सो लैक ऑफ अवेयरनेस जो है वो क्यों है? बिकॉज पॉपुलेशन बहुत ज्यादा है, सो गवर्नमेंट इतना ज्यादा अवेयरनेस फैलाना मैनेज नहीं कर पा रहा. नेक्स्ट, पुअर मैनेजमेंट ऑफ रिसोर्सेज बिकॉज ऑफ द सेम रीजन. गवर्नमेंट अटेंशन कम दे पा रही है बिकॉज इतना ज्यादा पॉपुलेशन है कि जो गवर्नमेंट है एक एक इंसान तक अवेयरनेस पहुंचाना इज क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम. एंड एक्सेसिव यूज ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर भी इसीलिए है बिकॉज द पॉपुलेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो वी कैन से द मेन एंड बेसिक रीजन फॉर दिस, फॉर रिड्यूसिंग एवरेज एनुअल पर कैपिटा वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी इंडिया, इज इंक्रीजिंग पॉपुलेशन. ऑलराइट, आई होप यू गेट द आंसर. Okay guys, so that's it for today's session. I hope you like it. Milte hain next session mein. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Goodbye, take care, God bless, and keep watching PIB 24/7.